It's so quiet that even regular marine life mistakes it as just one of its own. Yet the American-built underwater drone is large enough to deter any curious would-be predator, which all give it a wide berth. This unique vehicle is about the size of a small commercial fishing vessel, but when seen from above it looks like a giant manta ray cruising the world's oceans. It has no propellers, and the only visible oddity that marks the underwater vehicle as artificial, to a casual observer, is the large fin that sticks up in the back, like an aircraft tail. It's a predator unlike anything else in the ocean. The same silencing technology that makes American submarines legendarily quiet has gone into its construction. Though it's designed to be expendable, this makes it perfect for penetrating deep into dangerous enemy waters and carrying out the most dangerous of missions. This artificial fish is currently on the hunt for prey. The vehicle features both passive and active sonar, but it's currently cruising along at several knots using only its passive sonar and a host of highly classified sensors, all tuned into catching one of the biggest fish in the ocean, a Chinese attack submarine. And when it finds one, this predator has teeth with which to strike. Up above the waves, the U.S. manned fleet is stretched thin, trying to cover millions of square miles of ocean to keep the Chinese submarines away from shipping routes or even friendly ports back home. Only being able to bring a portion of its total navy to the fight in the Pacific, the United States has been working on a backup plan for years. The Ghost Fleet. The fleet of unmanned vehicles numbers over 100 semi or completely autonomous vessels, from surface combatants to mobile missile batteries, capable of backing up everything from manned warships to underwater hunters tasked with locating, tracking, and sometimes even destroying Chinese vessels, both above and below the surface. The artificial intelligence-powered artificial manta ray runs all of its sensory data against a library of known signatures from Chinese vessels, until finally there's a match. The big underwater drone banks silently and accelerates toward its target. Yet, even at top speed, it barely emits a whisper as it glides through the water. Nature has spent hundreds of millions of years achieving aquatic perfection, and the Americans are apt in their studies, emulating the natural movement and the design of manta rays for this sub-hunting drone. The Chinese submarine is busy listening for potential prey or predators with a delicate suite of electronic warfare equipment, specifically designed to sniff out enemy drones. However, the artificial manta ray gives off almost no electronic emissions. Onboard AI handles all the decisions a human operator would normally make. The vehicle is designed to engage known threats automatically, but only if it has a confidence rate of above 98%. If it's in any way in doubt about its target, the big drone will instead silently rise to the surface and extend a satellite antenna to send a microburst transmission to an orbiting satellite, relaying its location and the location of the tracked hostile. From there, a human operator will make the decision on what to do next. The drone can either follow the hostile or directly engage it. This time, though, the AI is 100% confident about its target. The Chinese submarine has unique acoustic signatures, and the drone is now in proximity to detect it with enough fidelity that it can even identify the exact submarine it's currently hunting. The AI selects a torpedo from its belly-mounted weapons bay, and a few seconds later, the weapon is silently released into the water. A second after that, the torpedo's battery brings its propulsion to life, and the deadly fish is en route to its target. There's no need to hide anymore, and both the drone and the torpedo turn on their active sonar. The Chinese boat is immediately alerted, and then terrified to discover just how close the American drone is. The confirmation of a torpedo in the water sends a chill down the captain's spine. There is little hope of evading such a close-range shot, but the submarine immediately ejects countermeasures. Noisemakers are ejected from the openings along the hull into the water, creating an extremely attractive sonar signature for both the drone and the torpedo. The torpedo is lured towards a noisemaker by the juicy sonar return, but the drone's artificial intelligence has identified the sudden spike in noise as countermeasures. It's still linked to the torpedo with a long enough fiber optic cable that spools out behind the torpedo as it travels through the water, and it relays commands to the torpedo to correct its course and ignore the countermeasures. The Chinese captain's face goes pale. There's nothing he can do now but order the boat to perform an emergency surfacing. Hopefully, they'll be near enough the surface when the torpedo strikes that most of the crew can escape the doomed submarine. The proceeding is a potential scenario where America's new sub-hunting drone could be used in case of a war in the Pacific against China. While many nations are pursuing drone programs for land, sea, subsea, and air applications, the United States has identified a need for a massive expansion of naval drones as a priority to ensure stability in the South Pacific. This comes as a result of China's increasingly hostile foreign policy in the South China Sea and in neighboring waters, with the nation bullying its neighbors for access to rich energy and fish resources that fall outside of China's own territorial waters. The situation is so tense that even Vietnam has thrown its lot in with the U.S. in an attempt to fend off China's aggression on the high seas. Earlier this year, the Chinese Navy wounded several Filipino sailors as they attempted to resupply Filipino troops stationed on a shoal inside the Philippines' own territorial waters that are claimed by China. The move has prompted many to wonder where the red line is that'll lead to open conflict. And it's not just its weaker regional neighbors that China is picking on. Last year, a Chinese destroyer pulled up alongside an Australian military vessel whose prop had been fouled by discarded fishing nets. The Australian captain alerted the Chinese ship that he had divers in the water, as is normal procedure. Rather than offer assistance, as any other nation navy would do, the Chinese captain instead ordered his ship's sonar to be briefly run at full power, injuring the Australian divers. Add in ever-mounting tensions with Taiwan, and a conflict with China seems all but certain. But if the U.S. is to face off against China, it needs to make up for its lack of numbers. Currently, the Chinese Navy outnumbers the Americans, but most Chinese ships are not suited for open water operations. Despite their superior numbers, U.S. ships are still better equipped and bring more missiles to the fight. But China is slowly closing that gap. To make matters worse, the U.S. Navy has global commitments it just cannot abandon, and thus it can only bring a portion of its full strength into a fight with China. This is where the Ghost Fleet and DARPA's new Manta Ray drone come into play. The U.S. is looking to add approximately 100 large unmanned platforms to its naval inventory by 2030, following a similar push by the U.S. Army and Marines, which are looking to acquire thousands of drones within the next 2 years. The Air Force was already planning to integrate drones in its future air fleets, with the collaborative combat aircraft concept being in development for years now alongside the next-generation air dominance fighter. This sixth-generation fighter will act as a mothership for a small fleet of expendable drones, which can then perform more dangerous tasks that the manned fighter would be at too great a risk for. The Navy's approach to drone warfare mirrors the Air Force's in that it's acquiring larger drones equipped with advanced artificial intelligence that will allow them to act either semi-autonomously or fully autonomously. This Ghost Fleet will supplement the manned fleet, leveling the playing field against superior Chinese numbers and allowing the Navy to send drones into waters too dangerous for manned ships. One key area in which naval drones will excel is where American Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency has been focusing many of its efforts: anti-submarine warfare. With threats of the Soviet Union submarines breaking out into the Atlantic and destroying U.S. reinforcements on their way to Europe, the U.S. placed major emphasis on anti-submarine warfare, or ASW, during the Cold War, becoming an expert in identifying, tracking, and hunting down these elusive assets. However, after the fall of the Soviet Union and with no major competitors on the horizon, the U.S.'s ASW capabilities atrophied to embarrassing levels, prompting the U.S. to borrow a Swedish submarine and its crew for an extended training regimen meant to restore the Navy's ASW proficiency. But the ocean is vast, and ASW can be very tedious. This is where DARPA's Manta Ray comes into play. The stealthy drone is designed to sniff out enemy submarines, though it's capable of tracking and identifying other threats as well. The path to the creation of the Manta Ray began back in 2020, when DARPA awarded contracts to Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and Navitech to begin development on a new type of drone. DARPA gave the defense contractors a description of what it wanted: an autonomous underwater vehicle able to operate on its own, harvest its own energy, and complete a variety of missions autonomously. A year later, Lockheed Martin dropped out of the race, and DARPA awarded Northrop Grumman and Navitech contracts to develop a full-scale technology demonstrator. In September 2023, Navitech, now known as PACMAR Technologies, began testing a smaller-scale prototype in open water to verify the effectiveness of its sensor suite and its ability to carry out autonomous tasks without human guidance. Northrop Grumman, however, seems to have beaten PACMAR to the punch, unveiling a full-scale technology demonstrator ready for open water trials. Dubbed the Manta Ray, the drone utilizes a sea glider shape that makes it look like a stealth bomber. The drone's been touted as being highly modular, which means it's easy to ship to wherever it's needed and easy to assemble once on location. This is important to the Navy, as it allows it to use transport aircraft to bring the drone wherever it's needed quickly and saves valuable pier space that other ships need. Ease in assembly also means that specialized technicians don't need to be present in theater wherever the drone is deployed, a key benefit given the vast size of the Pacific Ocean, where it's expected to serve the most. The Manta Ray features something truly extraordinary for any drone. A key requirement from the Navy was full autonomy for the drone. The Navy didn't want a drone that was just going to add more workload for its sailors, or require additional personnel to be recruited and trained in its operation. This is where artificial intelligence comes into play, allowing the drone to work alongside but independently of other vessels. But that's not all the autonomy that the Navy wanted, because the drone has to be completely self-sufficient as well. It is the ultimate fire-and-forget weapon, with the Manta Ray featuring the ability to actually generate its own electricity and thus removing it from complicated logistics chains. This is a massive win for the Navy, especially as otherwise it would face the prospect of having to set up refueling capabilities for drones that could be wandering the entire length and breadth of the Pacific Ocean and beyond. This is hard enough in peacetime, let alone under the stresses of wartime conditions. DARPA placed a premium on energy management when putting out design proposals for the Manta Ray. A requirement for extreme duration and independence means that a premium was placed on how the drone uses its onboard energy reserves, prompting the use of new techniques to minimize energy draw while operational. The effort has even led to the inclusion of Metron Incorporated, specifically to work on the drone's energy systems. The effort has been focused on finding ways of making the same amount of energy go even further than ever before, and this means a premium on conserving energy in the first place. The drone's unique Manta Ray shape helps it achieve this reduction in energy draw, with its ability to slip through the water in the same manner as its namesake fish, using a fraction of the power current drones use. But the drone also needs to generate its own electricity, and this might be the most novel piece of tech on board. Currently, underwater drones are either directly tethered to a surface ship from where they draw power, or they need to be chased by a support ship that can provide refueling as necessary. With the most long-duration drones currently having an operational range of only a few days, this is logistically challenging, especially if the Manta Ray and its many siblings are meant to travel far and wide in pursuit of hostile submarines. To make matters worse, today's underwater drones have massive power draws, mostly just from their propulsion systems, before taking into account things like sensors or payloads. This limits their endurance even more and places a greater logistical burden on the Navy. The Air Force doesn't have this problem thanks to its drone's ability to range widely or use extremely efficient means of propulsion and atmospheric winds to stay aloft for days at a time. The Navy is thus looking to replicate and then surpass the success of airborne drones by engineering them to draw energy directly out of the ocean itself. Currently, details on the Manta Ray remain extremely classified, but one of the suspected methods of generating electricity underwater without human assistance is the use of ocean currents themselves. The drone is envisioned dropping down to the bottom of the sea and then anchoring itself in place. It can then deploy a pinwheel-like device on a tether, catching the energy of ocean currents and converting it into an electrical charge. A similar method is already used in generating power around the world, known as wave energy conversion, so the concept is proven to work at large scale. The question is, can it work underwater and on a much smaller scale? Another possibility of producing energy is known as salinity gradient power. The power can be accessed via reversed electrodialysis, or RED. RED utilizes a stack of alternating cathode and anode exchanging perm-selective membranes that are alternatively filled with fresh water and seawater. The difference in salinity between the membranes generates electricity which can be captured and stored by the drone. Yet a third proposition is to simply create underwater gas stations for a whole fleet of drones, known as Mission Unlimited Unmanned Underwater Vehicle Stations. These refueling stations for underwater drones would be spread across the ocean. They would generate power by deploying a thermal energy pod, which generates electricity by harnessing the energy produced by the mixing of warm and cooler currents underwater. Permanently anchored to the seafloor, the Navy would dispense dozens or even hundreds of these refueling stations where its fleet of unmanned drones could regularly return to top off their batteries. A major obstacle for the deployment of the Manta Ray and similar drones is the challenge of long-range communications with any submerged vehicle. Due to the conductivity of water, radio waves cannot travel very far below the waves, which is why American submarines utilize very low-frequency communication systems that link up with five different antenna complexes the US has built around the world. Manta Ray could be equipped with a VLF antenna as well, but that still limits its ability to communicate. given the very low bandwidth associated with those types of communications. This is why autonomy is a key requirement. The manta rays simply cannot receive detailed instructions while deployed deep underwater, and forget about direct control in the same style as the US Air Force's drone operators. One solution is to equip the manta ray with a deployable antenna that can rise up to the surface and connect to orbiting satellites. Many submarines currently utilize such a system for high-bandwidth communications, though it comes with significant risk. Northrop Grumman, however, has developed what it calls expendable data bubbles, which the manta ray could expel from its body. These devices would then float to the surface and, upon breaching the waves, transmit information gathered by the drone. However, this communication would go strictly one way, making artificial intelligence the key to the entire concept working. With both Russia and China fielding new submarines, the need for a dramatic expansion in anti-submarine warfare is pressing, and the Manta Ray, along with a whole family of similar drones, could be the answer. These autonomous drones, autonomous even to the point of generating their own power, could be the edge that the US Navy needs to continue to deter any bad actor from starting an unfortunate war that would end up costing the entire world dearly. However, if such a war does kick off, America's underwater Skynet Terminators will soon be ready. Now go check out the truth about drone warfare in Ukraine, or click this other video instead.